everyone, welcome back. Earlier, we discussed about the structure of cell. In this video, we will discuss about cell envelope and osmosis. First, we will learn about cell envelope. Well, friends, do you know what is a cell envelope? You must have understood by the term itself that we are going to understand the outermost layers of the cell. Let's understand what is a cell envelope. It is made up of cell wall and cell membrane. First, let us know what is a cell wall. Cell wall. This is the outermost layer and it is present only in the plant cell. It surrounds the entire plant cell. Friends, you must have noticed that the plants are a bit rigid and complex. So, what could be the reason for this? Yes, because of this cell wall, as it is made up of complex substance called cellulose. It is very thick and rigid and provides structural support to the plant. So, what if the outermost layer of the cell is rigid? Yes, this will maintain the safety and the structure of the cell. It is a permeable membrane and a vital part of the cell. That is, this layer allows small particles to go in or out, and no organic chemical reaction takes place in it. Can you tell why are cell walls only in plant cells but not in animal cells? Just think. So, the answer is that plants live in the open environment and face bad weather like storm, hail or excess heat or very cold. That is why thick and hard cell walls are for greater protection. But animals can go to a safe place. That is why they do not need any additional protection. Let's understand another protective layer, and that is cell membrane or plasma membrane. Cell membrane or plasma membrane is the outermost layer of the animal cell. It separates the parts of the cell from the external environment, and it is present in both plant and animal cells. It is made up of proteins and lipids, which are very important biological molecules. Many cell organelles of the cell are made up of these biological molecules. It is a semi-permeable membrane. Now, what is the semi-permeable membrane? The semi-permeable membrane allows the passage of certain particles and stops the movement of other particles. That is why it is the living part of the cell. It maintains the size of the cell and also protects the internal structure of the cell. Now friends, what if the cell does not have a cell membrane? Friends, if you look at the animal cell, it is the same outer layer that gives it shape. If it is not present, then everything present inside will come out. But in plant cell, there is a cell membrane which gives shape, and there is a cell wall around it which provides protection to both the cell membrane and the cell. So friends, have you seen what is cell envelope? But do you know how particles move in this cell envelope? Let's understand. There are two ways: diffusion and osmosis. What is diffusion? Guys, have you ever heard the term diffusion? Diffusion is the process in which solid, liquid and gaseous substances move from high concentration to low concentration. For example, cell requires oxygen to produce energy. Let's understand. When the oxygen gas molecules reach the cell with the blood, the concentration of oxygen molecules outside the cell becomes higher than inside. So, what will happen here, friends? Yes, diffusion will occur. the oxygen molecules move from outside to the inside of the cell, and when the cell makes energy, carbon dioxide, that is CO2 gas, is produced in the cell, which has to go outside. Now, the concentration of carbon dioxide gas molecules in the cell is higher than outside. So, what will happen here? Again, the same diffusion. The movement of the molecules of carbon dioxide gas will be from inside to outside of the cells. So, in this way, the gases in the cell are transported by diffusion process. The second mode of transportation is osmosis. It is the process in which water moves from higher concentration to a low concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. In order to understand, let's perform an activity. Activity: take two glasses A and B. Add some water in glass A, then glass B. Now, mix equal amounts of sugar or salt in them and make a solution. Now, if both these solutions are compared, the concentration of water in glass A is higher than that of glass B. So, the solution of glass A will be called a hypotonic solution. While the concentration of water in glass B is lower than glass A, the solution of glass B is called hypotonic solution. Now, take another glass C, add the same amount of water and sugar or salt as you have taken in glass A. Now, if both glasses A and C are compared here, then the concentration of water in both will be the same. So, both solutions will be called isotonic solutions to each other. Similarly, take another glass D in which we will keep the amount of water and the quantity of sugar or salt as glass B. Now, here, when glass B and glass D are compared, then the concentration of water in both will be same. That is, both glass B and glass D will also be called isotonic solutions to each other. Now, friends, what will happen? If you put a cell into these solutions, let's see. First of all, put the cell in the hypotonic solution. In this solution, the concentration of water is less than that of the cell. So guys, what will happen here? Yes, osmosis. The water of the cell will come out of the plasma membrane, and gradually, the size of the cell will decrease. Now, put the cell in the hypotonic solution. Here, the concentration of water in the solution is higher than that of the cell. So guys, what do you think will happen? Yes, same, osmosis again. The water of the solution will enter the cell through the plasma membrane and the size of the cell increases. Now, what will happen if the cell is put in the same isotonic solution? Yes, you're thinking right. Here, there will be no transport of water at all because both have the same water concentration. Well, through this osmosis process, only plants absorb water from the soil. Let's see how. For example, here this plant is planted on the soil. There will also be water in the land and many salts dissolved in it. These salts are very important for the plants. Now, the amount of water in the root cells is less in the plant. So, the groundwater will act as a hypotonic solution. So friends, what should happen here? Yes, osmosis. The groundwater goes through the plasma membrane of the root cell into the cell and the cell swells and becomes thick. So friends, in this way, osmosis causes the transport of water and salts in plants. Summary: cell envelope is made up of cell wall and plasma membrane. In the next video, we will understand regarding nucleus and cytoplasm.